Hello friends, so in this video we are going to study the kinematic analysis of mechanism. So kinematic analysis is nothing but what? It is the branch of theory of machine which deals with the study of motion. Okay, so in this analysis we have to study the parameter related to the motion. Okay, there are various analytical methods, out of which the first method is the analytical method for displacement, velocity and acceleration analysis of slider crank mechanism, so which is also called as the IC engine mechanism. So here we have to consider the slider crank mechanism, in which whatever this point O is a fixed point which is fixed link. So whatever this OC is a crank which have the crank radius R. This CP is nothing but what? The connecting rod which have the length L, and this P is nothing but what? The piston which is sliding along this line of stroke. Okay. Now this theta is nothing but what? The angular displacement of the crank or angle turned by this crank with respect to this IDC. Okay. Similarly, this angle phi is nothing but what? Angle made by this connecting rod with respect to this line of stroke. Okay. As we have discussed, kinematic analysis is nothing but what? The study of motion parameters. We have to find out the various motion parameter. So in this case, O is a fixed link, so it will not have any motion. Whatever this OC is an input link, so input parameter or input notion that we will know from the input data. Whatever this CP will have the angular velocity, angular displacement and angular acceleration. Whatever this piston will have the linear displacement, linear velocity and linear acceleration. So now we have to find out, the relation for this displacement of piston. From that you can easily find out the velocity and acceleration. So we'll start with the displacement of piston. So now if I consider this OC is at IDC, that is crank is at IDC. So at that time, whatever this piston will be at P1. Okay. Now if I consider the crank which is at IDC turned by angle theta, then at that time whatever this piston will move by the distance, by some distance to the point P. Okay. When this crank turned by angle theta, so at that time whatever this piston which is at P1 will move to new position, that is point P. So whatever this XP is nothing but what? The displacement of piston when the crank turned by angle theta. Now we have to find out the value of or equation for this XP. Okay, so whatever this XP, displacement of piston, see here, so XP is nothing but what? Distance from P1 to P. So how to find out that P1 to P? So for that you have to consider this distance P1 to O and this distance P to O. If I subtract this P1 O from this PO, you will get this displacement P1 to P. Okay. So whatever, so you can write this equation P1 P is equal to P1 O minus PO. Now we have to find out the value of this P1 O and this PO. Okay. So in order to find out the value of P1O, you have to consider this crank OC is at IDC. Okay, so whatever this C point will be at IDC point. So whatever this OC is nothing but what? The crank length, that is R. And whatever the C point to the P1 point is nothing but what? The length of connecting rod, that is L. So you can write this like this way, OP1. Whatever this O2P1 is nothing but what? R plus L. Okay, so whatever this P1O is nothing but what? L plus R minus PO. Now you have to find out the distance P2O. So whatever this P2O is nothing but what? Distance OM and distance MP. This distance P2O is nothing but what? Addition of OM and MP. Now we have to find out the value of this OM first and MP. Okay, so for that you have to consider this angle OCM. Consider this triangle OCM. So angle is theta. So you can use the cos relation. So cos is nothing but what? The adjacent, that is OM upon hypotenuse, that is OC. So you can consider cos theta is equal to OM upon hypotenuse. So hypotenuse side is OC, that is R. So you can consider cos theta is equal to OM upon R. Therefore, OM will be equal to what? R into cos theta. So keep in mind, OM is nothing but what? R into cos theta. Similarly, you have to find out the value of this MP. Okay, so for that, consider this triangle CMP. consider this triangle CMP. So again, if I consider cos phi is nothing but what adjacent, that is MP upon hypotenuse CP. So cos phi will be equal to MP upon L. So MP will be equal to what? L into cos phi. So we will get the value of MP is what? L into cos phi. Okay, now put this value of OM value is what? R into cos theta. And MP value is what? L into cos phi. So put here. So PO. So this PO is nothing but what? OM plus MP. OM value is R into cos theta. And MP value is what? L into cos phi. Now, if I simplify this equation. Means multiply this minus inside the bracket. So you will get L plus R minus R into cos theta minus L into cos phi. So now if I consider this two term R minus R into cos theta. So you can take R common, right? So you will get this term, that is R into 1 minus cos theta. Now if I consider this L and minus L cos phi, from this also you can take this L common. So L into 1 minus cos phi. Okay, so this will be the equation in terms of theta and phi, but we don't know the value of this phi. So for that, what we have to do, we have to find out the relation between the theta and phi. Okay, so for that you have to again consider this figure, consider this triangle OCM and CMP. So to the consider this triangle OCM and triangle CMP. So for both this triangle, CM is a common side. And if you find out this CM common side, you will get the relation of this theta and phi. Okay. So consider this triangle OCM. We have to find out this value CM. So you can consider sine theta is equal to CM upon OC. Sine theta is nothing but what? Opposite upon hypotenuse. That is CM upon OC. So you can consider CM is nothing but what? OC into sine theta. That is R into sine theta. Similarly, you can find out the value of this CM for this triangle CMP. Okay, so CM, in consider this triangle CMP. So whatever this sine phi will be equal to what? CM upon CP. That is opposite upon hypotenuse. CM upon CP. So you can consider CM will be equal to what? L into sine phi. CM is equal to what? L into sine phi. So if you consider this CM for this triangle OCM, so this CM is R into sine theta. And if I consider this CM to this triangle CMP, so this CM is nothing but what? L into sine phi. So you can write this equation like this way. CM is equal to R into sine theta is equal to L into sine phi. Okay, if I simplify this, so sine phi will be equal to what? R upon L into sine theta. Now we have to, here you have to consider this N term. So N is nothing but what? The obliquity ratio. N is nothing but what? The obliquity ratio, which is nothing but what? Ratio of length of connecting rod to the length of crank. Okay, that is N is equal to L upon R. So here R by L. So you can consider the value of R by L is 1 by N. So you can write this equation like this way. Sine phi will be equal to sine theta upon N. Okay. As we require the value of cos phi, so you can consider this relation, sine square phi plus cos square phi is equal to 1. Therefore cos phi will be equal to what? Under root of 1 minus sine square phi, right? So cos phi will be equal to value of sine phi is what? Sine theta upon y. Simply put the value of sine phi is equal to sine theta upon n. So cos phi will be equal to under root of 1 minus sine theta upon n bracket square. Now if I simplify this term, so you will get this equation, that is cos phi is equal to under root of n square minus sine square theta upon n. Okay, now put this value of cos phi in equation 1. Okay, so you will get this equation, xp is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta plus l into 1 minus under root of n square minus sine square theta upon n. So if you take this n square, outside this square root, so that will be n. Okay, therefore again if I consider this value of L, so from this equation L is nothing but what? R into n. So you can put L is equal to what? N into R. Okay, now if I multiply this n inside the bracket, so what will happen? You will get this term like this way. Okay, so xp is equal to whatever the first term will remain as it is. Simply have to multiply this n inside the bracket. Okay, so r into 1 minus cos theta plus r into bracket. We have multiplied this n inside the bracket. So n minus under root of n square minus sin square theta, and whatever this n will get cancel out. Okay, so you will get this equation of displacement of piston. Xp is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta plus r into n minus under root of n square minus sin square theta. So this will be what? The displacement of piston when the crank is turned by angle theta. Okay, so once you find out the displacement, you can easily find out the velocity of piston, because velocity of piston is nothing but what? It is the rate of change of displacement of piston. Therefore, Vp is nothing but what? Rate of change, that is d by dt of xp, that is displacement of piston. So you can write this equation like this way. Vp is equal to d by dt of xp, as this equation consists of theta. So here you have to apply the chain rule. So dxp upon d theta multiplied by d theta upon dt. Now if I consider this term d theta upon dt, so whatever this theta is nothing but what? The angular displacement of the crank. So rate of change of angular displacement is nothing but what? The angular velocity, that is omega multiplied by dxp upon d theta. So you can replace this d theta upon dt by value omega. Okay. Now what we have to do in next step, you have to put the value of this xp. So we know the value of xp. Xp is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta plus r into bracket n minus under root of n square minus sin square theta. Okay, put here, take the derivative with respect to theta. Now in this case, whatever this r is common to both this term, so you can take the outside the derivative sign, because r is a constant term, r is a crank radius which is constant. So you can take the outside the derivative sign, that is omega into r into the bracket d by d theta. Now if I take this derivative of this 1 minus cos theta, you can say take the derivative separately. Okay, so derivative of 1 minus cos theta is what? Derivative of 1 will be 0 minus, so minus sign will remain as it is. So derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. So you can consider derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta plus, you have to take the derivative of this term n minus under root of n square minus sin square theta. So derivative of n will be 0 minus, you have to consider this term as a x term. So derivative of root x will be what? 1 upon 2 into root x. So value of x is what? N square minus sin square theta. And again you have to take the derivative of this x term, that is n square minus sin square theta. So derivative of n square will be 0 minus derivative of sin square theta will be what? 2 into sin theta. And again you have to take the derivative of this sin theta, that is nothing but what? Cos theta. So here you will get the derivative of this sin square theta as 2 into sin theta into cos theta. Okay, now if I simplify this equation, so this minus minus will become plus. So first term will remain as it is. So Vp is equal to omega into r. So this minus into minus plus, so plus sin theta plus. So whatever this minus, and again here also one minus is there. So minus minus plus, 2 into sin theta is into cos theta is nothing but what? Sin 2 theta, right? So sin 2 theta upon 2 into under root. So this term will remain as it is. 2 into under root of n square minus sin square theta. Okay. Now we have to consider the value of L. So whatever the value of L is always greater than 1. So that's why whatever the value of obligatory ratio is always greater than 1. So if I consider whatever the value of n square is very very large as compared to sin square theta. So value of this sin square theta is very small as compared to n square. Okay, so you can neglect this sin square theta term. So if I neglect this sin square theta, so whatever the value of this root is what? N square minus sin square theta. So under root of n square minus sin square theta is equal to, if I neglect this sin square theta, so you will get root of n square, and root of n square is nothing but what? N. So you can replace this whole term by n value n. So Vp is equal to what? Omega into r into the bracket sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. As it is a velocity, so its unit will be in meter per second or mm per second or centimeter per second. So this will be the velocity. Now we have to find out the next parameter, that is acceleration of piston. Now how to find out the acceleration of piston? So acceleration is nothing but what? The rate of change of velocity of piston. Okay, so AP will be equal to what? DVP upon DT. That is rate of change of velocity of piston. Okay, so again, whatever the equation of velocity of piston consists of theta term, so you have to apply this chain rule. So DVP upon D theta multiply by D theta upon DT, right? Again, so whatever this D theta upon DT is nothing but what? Rate of change of angular displacement, that is angular velocity. So AP will be equal to what? Omega into DVP upon D theta. So here put the value of this VP. So value of VP is what? Omega into R multiply by sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. Okay, so you will get this equation. Now before going to proceed for the further step, I will explain you the two cases. That is, case one is what? The crank rotates with uniform angular velocity. So whatever the input link, either it rotates with uniform angular velocity or it will rotate with non-uniform angular velocity. So that two cases we have to consider. So first case is what? If we assume that crank is rotated with uniform angular velocity, that is omega is constant. And second case is what? The crank is rotates with non-uniform angular velocity. So in that case, omega will not be constant, because as the angular velocity changes, so that element will possess some angular acceleration. Rate of change of angular velocity is nothing but what? Angular acceleration. So while taking the derivative, we have to consider these two cases. So first case is what? Omega is constant, that is crank is rotates with uniform angular velocity. So in that case, whatever this omega is constant, so that will be outside the derivative sign. Okay, so that's why whatever this whole term omega into R, so that will come outside the derivative sign. So that will be omega square into R, omega into R multiply by omega. So that will be omega square into R. So you have to take the derivative of this term only, that is d by d theta of sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. Okay, so derivative of sin theta is cos theta, and derivative of sin 2 theta will be what? Cos 2 theta. Sin, derivative of sin is cos. So cos 2 theta multiply by derivative of this 2 theta. So derivative of this 2 theta is 2. Okay, so whatever this 2 will get cancelled. So you will get this equation, AP is equal to omega square into R into the bracket cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon L. So this is the equation of acceleration of piston when crank moves with angular velocity, constant angular velocity, that is omega is equal to constant. Now we have to see the second case. Second case is what? The omega is not constant, means crank is rotate with non-uniform angular velocity. Okay, so in that case, we cannot take this omega outside the derivative sign. In first case, we have to take this omega outside the derivative sign because this omega is constant. Once again, I am repeating, in case one, this omega is constant, so that's why we have taken the outside the derivative sign. If this omega is not constant, we are not going to take this omega outside the derivative sign. Okay, so that is the second case. Okay, now if I consider the same equation, AP is equal to omega into D by D theta omega into R sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon N. So now in this case, only R, this R is constant, so you can take this outside the derivative sign. And whatever this omega is not constant, okay, so you can consider this omega into R D by D theta multiply by omega into sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice N. Okay, now here there are two terms. First term is the omega and second term is this bracket term, that is sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. Now here you have to apply the product rule or UV rule. First term as it is derivative of second plus second term as it is derivative of first. So you can apply the product rule here. So first term as it is, the derivative of second. So derivative of second will be what? Sin theta derivative will be cos theta plus sin 2 theta derivative will be 2 into cos theta upon twice n plus second term as it is. So second term will remain as it is multiplied by derivative of first, that is d omega upon d theta. Okay, now we have to find out the value of this d omega upon d theta. So for that you have to consider this d omega upon d theta multiply and divide by dt. Okay, so you will get this d omega upon dt into d theta upon dt. Simply what I have done, I have multiplied this equation and divide this equation by dt. So for this equation I have multiplied by and divide by dt, so you will get d omega upon dt multiply by dt upon d theta. So whatever this d omega upon dt is nothing but what, alpha. Omega is angular velocity, so rate of change of angular velocity is nothing but what, angular acceleration. And whatever this d theta upon dt is nothing but what, 1 by omega. So d theta upon dt is nothing but what, omega. So you can take the reciprocal, that is 1 by omega. So you will get the value of d omega upon d theta as alpha by omega. So put here, put value of d omega upon d theta in this equation, and you can simplify this equation. Okay, so AP will be equal to what, omega into R into the bracket omega into the bracket cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n plus R into alpha upon omega. Here omega is there, so you can consider alpha upon omega multiply by sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. Again I am repeating here, alpha upon omega is there. Okay, so alpha upon omega multiply by sin theta upon sin 2 theta upon twice n. Now you can multiply this omega R inside the bracket, so you will get this term, that is AP is equal to R into omega square. AP is equal to R into omega square into the bracket cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n plus, here term is what, alpha upon omega, and we have multiplied by omega into R, so on omega will get cancelled and you will get this term R into alpha into the bracket sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. So this is the equation of acceleration of piston when the crank rotates with non-uniform angular velocity. Okay, so this is the equation, that is AP is equal to omega square into R cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. So this equation is applicable when the crank rotates with uniform angular velocity, and this equation is applicable when the crank rotates with non-uniform angular velocity. In problem it is given whether crank is rotates with uniform angular velocity or non-uniform angular velocity. Okay, so up to this we have find out the displacement of piston, velocity of piston, and the acceleration of piston in two cases, omega is constant and omega is not constant. Okay, now we will go to the next link, that is connecting rod. Now here we have to find out the angular velocity. Already we have find out the relation of phi and theta, so from this you can find out the angular displacement of connecting rod. Okay, now we have to find out the angular velocity of connecting rod. So for that we have to consider omega is nothing but what, d theta upon dt, that is angular velocity of crank. Omega c is nothing but what, angular velocity of connecting rod, which is nothing but what, d phi upon dt. Alpha is nothing but what, the angular acceleration of crank, that is d omega upon dt. Alpha c is nothing but what, the angular acceleration of connecting rod, that is nothing but what, d omega c upon dt. Okay, now in order to find out the angular velocity of connecting rod, we have to consider this relation sin phi is equal to sin theta upon n, which we have derived in the first few steps, right? So sin phi is equal to sin theta upon n. Now in order to find out the angular velocity, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to time. So differentiate this equation with respect to time. So d by dt of sin phi plus d by dt of sin theta upon n. Okay, here if I take the derivative of this sin phi, so that will be what, cos phi into d phi upon dt, or you can consider d by dt of sin phi is what, d by dt into sin phi multiply by, you have to take the derivative of this phi, that is d phi upon dt. So it will be what, cos phi multiply by d phi upon dt. So this d phi upon dt is nothing but what, here omega c is nothing but what, d phi upon dt. So you can consider cos phi multiply by omega c. Similarly you have to take the derivative of this term, so sin theta upon n, so n will be constant, so that will remain that will be outside the derivative sign. So derivative of cos theta is what, so derivative of sin theta is cos theta multiply by the derivative of this theta, that is d theta upon dt. So cos theta multiply by omega divided by n. As we have to find out the value of omega c, so you can take this cos phi to the RHS, so omega upon n multiply by cos theta upon cos phi. Simply take this cos phi to the RHS. So omega upon n multiplied by cos theta upon cos phi. As we know this, as we have to eliminate this phi, already we have find out the value of this cos phi. So the value of cos phi is what? The under root of n square minus sin square theta upon n. So put this value of cos phi under root of n square minus sin square theta upon n here. So whatever this n, n will get cancelled. And again, already we have discussed that whatever this value of n square is very very larger than the sin square theta. So you can neglect this sin square theta. So under root of n square is nothing but on n. So this is the relation, or this is the equation of omega c, that is angular velocity of connecting rod. Omega c is equal to omega into cos theta upon n. So by using this equation, you can find out the angular velocity of the connecting rod, okay, which will be in rad per second. Okay, we have find out the angular velocity of connecting rod. Now next, we have to find out the angular acceleration of the connecting rod. Again, while calculating the angular acceleration, we have to consider the two cases, that is omega is constant and omega is not constant. Okay, so first we will write the basic steps, that is alpha c is nothing but dot d omega c upon dt. Angular acceleration is nothing but dot rate of change of angular velocity. So alpha c indicates what? The angular acceleration of connecting rod. And this omega c indicates what? The angular velocity of connecting rod. Okay, so alpha c will be equal to d omega c upon dt. Now here this equation consists of theta, so here you have to apply the chain rule. So d omega c upon d theta multiply by d theta upon dt. So whatever this d theta upon dt is nothing but what? Omega. And multiply by d omega c upon d theta. So we have to put the value of omega c. So value of omega c is omega into cos theta upon n. Okay, so omega multiply by d by d theta of omega into cos theta upon n. So whatever this omega by n, whatever this n will be constant. So that will be outside the derivative sign. So here you have to consider the two cases. So first case is what? The omega is constant. As this omega is constant, so that will be outside the derivative sign. That will be outside the derivative sign. Means what? This omega multiply by omega. So that will be omega square divided by n. Okay, and you have to take the derivative of this cos theta. So derivative of cos theta is what? Minus sin theta. Okay, so you will get this equation. Alpha c is equal to minus of omega square into sin theta upon n. Now here negative sign indicates that whatever the direction of rotation of crank and connecting rod will be same. Means what? If the angular acceleration is negative, so in that case whatever the direction of rotation of crank and connecting rod will be same. Okay, now we have considered the first case, that is omega is constant. Omega constant, as omega is constant, so that will be outside the derivative sign. So now we have to consider the second case. If the angular velocity of connecting rod is, if the angular velocity of crank is not constant. Okay, so in that case you have to consider this omega inside the derivative sign. Okay, so you can consider this omega inside the derivative sign. So this n will be outside the derivative sign. So here you can consider alpha c is equal to what? Omega into d by d theta. So this n is a constant, so that will be outside the derivative sign. Again, whatever this omega into cos theta, so here you have to apply the product rule, because we are not allowed to take this omega outside the derivative sign, because omega is not constant in second case. Okay, so here you can apply the product rule, omega into cos theta. So first term as it is, derivative of second, derivative of cos theta is what? Minus sin theta, plus second term as it is, that is cos theta multiplied by d omega upon d theta. So already we have find out the value of this d omega by d theta is nothing but what? Alpha by omega. So put d omega upon d theta, that is alpha by omega, in this equation. So you will get this step, that is omega by n multiply by minus of omega sin theta plus cos theta into alpha by omega. Okay, so multiply this omega by n into the bracket. So you will get alpha c is equal to minus of omega square into sin theta upon n plus alpha into cos theta upon n. So this is the equation of angular acceleration of connecting rod when crank is rotated with non-uniform angular velocity. And this is the equation of angular acceleration of connecting rod when crank rotates with uniform angular velocity. Okay, so this is about the analytical method for finding out the displacement, velocity and acceleration of this piston and connecting rod. Again, I am repeating, we have to find out the equation of displacement of piston, velocity of piston, acceleration of piston for both the cases, that is omega is constant and omega is not constant. Again, we have to find out the angular acceleration of connecting rod, angular velocity of connecting rod and angular acceleration for both the cases, omega is constant, omega is not constant. Okay, now we will see the some numerical based on this. So numerical is what? In a slider crank mechanism, a stroke of the slider is 200 mm and obliquity ratio is 4.5. the crank rotates uniformly at 1000 rpm in clockwise direction. When the crank angle is 30 degree past the ODC, find out the velocity and acceleration of piston and angular velocity and angular acceleration of connecting rod. Okay, now you can write down the given data. So given data is what? The stroke of the slider. Stroke is nothing but what? You can consider capital L. Small L is a connecting rod length and capital L is a stroke length. So whatever this capital L is 200 mm, so convert it into meter, so this will be 0.2 meter. Okay, now if I consider the relation between the crank radius and stroke length, so that is nothing but what? R is equal to L by 2. So this is the relation between the crank radius and stroke length, that is capital L by 2. So R is equal to capital L by 2. So R will be equal to what? 0.2 by 2. So you will get the value of R as a 0.1 meter. Okay. Next, they have given the obliquity ratio 4.5, that is value of N. So you can consider N is equal to L upon R. Therefore, L is equal to what? L is equal to what? N into R. So 4.5 into 0.1, so you will get the value of L, that is 0.45. Okay. After that, they have given the crank rotates uniformly at 100 rpm. Okay, crank rotates uniformly at 100 rpm, so that is nothing but what? Value of N. So N is 1000 rpm, so from that you can find out the value of omega. Omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60, so you will get this 104.719 rad per second. Next, they have given the crank angle 30 degree past the ODC. So angle from, you have to consider this angle theta. Keep in mind, always you have to consider this theta from IDC, as they have given 30 degree past the ODC. So whatever the angle from IDC to ODC is 180, and this 30 is past the ODC, so you can consider theta is equal to 180 plus 30, that is 210 degree. And here it is rotates with uniform angular velocity, that is alpha is equal to 0. We have to find out the velocity and acceleration of piston, that is Vp is equal to Ap, and angular velocity and angular acceleration, that is omega c and alpha c. So you know the value of equation of Vp. Vp is equal to R into omega sin theta plus sin 2 theta upon twice n. Simply put the values. You know the value of R, you know the value of omega, you know the value of theta. Put the values, you will get this Vp. So Vp is coming negative sign, in negative, that is minus of 4.228 meter per second. So here, if the velocity of the piston is negative, so that will indicate that piston is moving away from the crank end. Okay, as here they have given the angle from ODC. Okay, when the crank moves from IDC to ODC, at that time piston will move towards the crank end. And when the piston when the crank moves from ODC to IDC, so in that case piston will move away from the crank end. Okay, or from this sign also you can find out that relation, whether piston is moving towards the crank head or away from the crank head. If the velocity is positive, then in that case piston will move towards the crank head. And if the velocity is negative, then in that case the piston will move away from the crank end. Okay, so keep in mind this relation. If the value is negative, piston will move away from the crank end. And if the value is positive, then it will move towards the crank end. Now we have to find out the acceleration of piston. So its formula is what? R into omega square cos theta upon n. Simply you can take the derivative and you can write this equation also. Okay, put the all the values, you will get the value of this AP. So AP is minus 827.844 meter per second square. Negative sign, again piston is moving from crank away from the crank end. Now next we have to find out the omega c and alpha c. One thing I want to tell you that here we have used this first equation, that is omega is constant because in numerical they have given the omega crank rotates uniformly, so that's why you have to use the acceleration equation when omega is constant. Okay, otherwise you have to go for the second case. Okay, now similarly next omega c, that is angular velocity of connecting rod. So omega c is equal to omega into cos theta upon n. Put all the values, you will get this value of omega c. As this value is minus, so negative sign indicates that the direction of crank and connecting rod is same. So keep in mind, if the omega c is negative, in that case the crank and connecting rod will rotate in a same direction. Means crank, if crank rotates in a clockwise, then connecting rod also rotates in a clockwise direction. And if the value is positive, then in that case crank and connecting rod will rotate in a opposite direction, or whatever the direction of rotation will be opposite. Okay, next find out the value of alpha c, angular acceleration. Here omega is constant, so you can use the case 1 equation. Okay, so alpha c will be equal to minus of omega square into sine theta upon n. Put all the values, you will get this value of alpha c. Okay, sometimes they will ask you the direction. Now here as the crank moves from ODC, so means what, it is moving in a clockwise direction. So whatever the value direction of this omega c, here the sign is negative, means what, both rotates in a same direction. As crank rotates in a clockwise direction, whatever the omega c will be in clockwise direction, and alpha c will be also in clockwise direction. Okay, now similarly you can solve this second numerical. So in which the IC engine speed is 2000 rpm, the connecting rod is of 270 mm, crank radius 60 mm, so directly they have given the value of L and R. Okay, determine at 30% of outstroke, you have to find out the various value, linear velocity, angular position of crank, linear acceleration of piston, angular acceleration, angular velocity and crank angle for maximum piston velocity. Okay, so you can write down this given data. You can write this given data, N, omega, L, R, N. Okay, so they have given whatever this XP, displacement is nothing but what, the 30% of outstroke. So you can consider outstroke is equal to instroke, so that is nothing but what, twice of R. Okay, so you can consider XP is equal to, that is displacement of piston is equal to 0.3 multiplied by twice R. Outstroke or instroke is nothing but what, twice of crank radius, that is stroke length. So you can consider XP is equal to 0.3 multiplied by twice R. So you can find out the value of this XP. Okay, so XP is how much, 0.036 meter. Okay, once you find out this value of XP, you can find out this unknown parameter theta. Put all the values, you don't know the value of theta, that we have to find out. Okay, so here you have to find out the angular position of crank. Okay, so once you find out the displacement, we know the displacement. Now in this equation only theta is unknown, so you can find out this unknown theta, and this value will be 60.987. put all the values, simplify the equation, apply the quadratic equation formula, from that you will get this value of theta. Okay, similarly you have to find out the velocity. Once you find out the theta, you can easily find out the velocity, you can easily find out the acceleration. Now in this case the velocity and acceleration is positive, means what, the piston will move towards the crank end. Okay, as this velocity is positive, means what, the piston will move towards the crank end. Similarly find out the omega c, alpha c. Already I have explained in the first numerical. Simply put the values, you can find out the omega c, alpha c. Okay, and last you have to find out the crank angle for maximum piston velocity. Okay, last is what, the crank angle for maximum piston velocity. Now keep in mind, the velocity will be maximum when its acceleration will be zero, that is AP will be equal to zero. So AP is nothing but what, dvp upon dt. Keep in mind, maximum velocity of piston is nothing but what, AP, that is acceleration of piston is equal to zero. When velocity will be maximum, at that point the acceleration will be zero. Okay, so dvp upon dt will be equal to zero, that is dvp upon dt is nothing but what, this AP. dVP upon dt is nothing but what? AP. Okay, so put the value of VP. VP formula of VP is nothing but what? R into omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n. Okay, put all this value, this R omega square come to this side, so it will become 0. So you can simplify this equation. Cos 2 theta is nothing but what? 2 cos square theta minus 1 upon n. Okay, you can put the value of n. You can simplify this equation and you can find out the value of this theta. So you will get the quadratic equation, solve that quadratic equation. So from that you will get this value of theta as 78.287, at which the velocity of the piston will be maximum. Okay, so this is related to the kinematic analysis of mechanism by using analytical method. Okay, hope you understand this video. If you have any doubt, you can make the comment on my video. Thank you.